Blog Talk Radio.
Yeah, talk, but I walk the walk. School Street, home of the brave. New York. Y'all make movies, but I make moves. I'm straight up. Y'all got something to prove. Y'all tuck, but I swing back. Y'all run, but I bring gas. Y'all whisper, X-Crackhead. Ice boom. I'ma just crack pain. A bass set across the line. Y'all talk from way behind. I stand my ground, but y'all don't. I go to jail, but y'all won't. Y'all walk around like you're scared, but this moves to the beat. Sit there and I'm ahead, but won't move my feet. Gangsta, so I'm holding up the wall. Head dancing, but up to the rest of y'all.
And y'all just flex. Rides y'all rapping when I got neck. You roll with them and I rock with that. Eastside motherfucker, Cleveland Brown. Burning leaves in the gut, I'm making Cleveland loud. All I know is when the beats on the beats come out. EST is in the building, we run this town. Rough Riders, you got a problem? Come find us. Pop up like the Sandman right behind you. Like where the cheese? Hey, lasagna. Pair of shoe size bags, loose stuff inside them. Grimy, spare hand, no tool beside me. I don't talk online, hater, come here, find me. Me against the world, underdogs, new rock. You giving a proof, anyone co-sign me like that.
I ain't a dancer, but this moves to the beat. Sit there and I'm ahead, but won't move my feet. Gangster, so I'm holding up the wall. Head dancing, but up to the rest of y'all. I ain't a dancer, but this moves to the beat. Sit there and I'm ahead, but won't move my feet. Gangster, so I'm holding up the wall. Head dancing, but up to the rest of y'all. Y'all niggas, straight up.
I keep that thing, and I'll play. It's you, not me, that's cool.
Y'all niggas walk, light on your toes. I come through hard, kicking down doors. I spit a mean 16 without a pause. Then let 16 go just because. I'm in it for the dough, I'm in it for life. You in jail beating me, I'm black, your wife. I bring the drama, I bring the noise. Kidnap your mama, bring them to them boys. I make what happen with one word.
You take black, laughing, use the bird.
I take for everything they got. That's why I'm the dog and you not. But this moves to the beat. Sit there and I'm ahead, but won't move my feet. Gangster, so I'm holding up the wall. Head dancing, but up to the rest of y'all. I ain't dancing, but this moves to the beat. Sit there and I'm ahead, but won't move my feet. Gangster, so I'm holding up the wall. Head dancing, but up to the rest of y'all. I ain't a dancer, but this moves to the beat. Sit there and I'm ahead, but won't move my feet. Gangster, so I'm holding up the wall. Head dancing, but up to the rest of y'all.
We want to thank you all for coming to the Q Media Nation show here on Blog Talk Radio. You know, nobody does it liver than us for the urban online community that is all around the world. Tonight you are with your host, Sister Falana, along with a few other choice guests. Tonight we have Jersey's own Primavera. I know he's already on the line. We had been eagerly anticipating him. He called in a little bit early ahead of us because we were just finishing up some stuff here. So thank you so much for calling in. And of course, you know we are your source for independent thought, politics, money, music, and life. Miss Tonye should be with us in a few. She had to do some stuff down in Orlando, Florida after just getting back from Atlanta. So we are just eagerly awaiting everyone to come into the chat room who was on last night with us so that we can get your questions out to Primavera if you have those. You know, we've been publicizing him since we started the show back up earlier this week, and we've been playing his commercials, his promos. Of course, Watch the Casket Bounce has been one of the hottest videos on our channel, so you need to go there and check it out for yourself, the Indie Artist Movement on YouTube, Indie Artist Movement on our YouTube channel, where the artists get paid for their plays, not have to pay to get plays. So we want to welcome you into the Q Media Nation show. If you have an opportunity to go onto our Facebook, it is Indie Talk Japan, or you can check us out at Kamai Muhammad 1. So check us out on the Facebook if you want to get into the chat there. Or if you want to get into the Q Media Nation radio chat, you can do so on the Q Media, on the Blog Talk page. We're there too. So we got a lot of things going in the studio tonight. It's Friday. It is hot as Hades outside. So if you're out and about, kind of try to stay warm. If you're on the phone, don't get caught while you out there driving. Or if you're on your bike or whatever, I want to thank some folks for coming by the studio and dropping off their music, letting us know exactly how you do it and where you're from. If you sent us emails with your music, we are loading music as we speak, so you will be able to hear some of your new cuts. And, of course, if you want to call in, it's 347-426-3974. Catch us on the web at www.blogtalkradio.com/Q Media Nation. So we're going to get into one more song, and then we're going to bring Primavera in. I want you all to hear his song for yourself if you have not heard it before, because we invited quite a few new people to. We want to thank Travis for reaching out to us, to Ali Bilal, and of course last night we had Abby. So we want to thank Santiago, and jumping down to Houston, we want to thank the team down there, the independent film companies that have reached out to us to support their independent films, and back up to Boston, to Jersey Cal for moving from New Jersey and making it happen up in the Boston area. Of course, to Shane out there in California, and to Pinky, who's all the way in New Mexico, and to the 500 boys that are out there in Albuquerque, we thank you. To Doc, who's in Las Vegas, I know you all are listening to the show. I see your telephone numbers. I know that you're calling in, and I also see that you've been sending us some emails. So we're going to get into this song real quick, and then we'll be back with you in just a few moments.
I'm the hardest to speak my life when they hand me the mic. So I'm just another gangster that made it. Go around your face with a blade, acting like I came here to shave it. They said hip hop is dead, but I ain't come here to save it. I'm just trying to get my cash and bounce. Y'all niggas is whack, you burn faster than a half an ounce. Shoot the pallbearers just to see the casket bounce. I'm the sickest nigga, wicked nigga, ask about. Leos come blasted out, destroyed with the faster route. No doubt, leaving a whole crew assed out, leaving your whole squad passed out. Blowing up like a station that's gassed out. I can go round for round, pound for pound, taking any lyrics who's down with my sound. Success street bound, on a one-way stop, ready to lace every track that I drop. Ready to take the crown with every lyric I drop. Waiting for the people to tell me to stop. I'ma beat the post out the lot, reap the reward. Kill your place, plot, swing my sword. Y'all niggas is whack, eagle on the track. Feel the impact when I attack. You gas down to the draws, catch the eagle claws. Yeah, excuse me as I fall. Sharpen up the crust, the eyes out your skull. You two dogs, tower over midgets, we stand tall. I eat a fireball, spit a common star. Step and catch the triple law. The roof, the rigor, the fucking revolver. That's what happens when you play with the bullets that follow. Blood money, killer dollars. I lay tracks, triple X. Music's porn, your heart get torn, playing with the devil's horns.
All right, all right, all right, all right, all right. We are live in the studio, online studio, with Primavera, who is hanging out in hot-ass New Jersey. Yes, I said hot-ass, because it's hot. It's hot as I don't know what, New Jersey. If hell is anything like this, I'm going to do really, really, really good from now until I die. But that's just a little joke for us Jersey folks, you know, stinky New Jersey. That's what everybody always calls New Jersey, but hell, I'm a Jersey girl, born and raised. Left a couple of times, but it's always called home. Primavera, I want to welcome new to the show, and are you enjoying this hot Jersey weather?
You know, in a way I am, because it's summertime, you know, and everyone, you know, they be out with the cars and the bikes, and the girls be out and all, but, you know, I'm getting older, you know, so I'm in with the AC on like an old man, you know what I mean? So, but I'm enjoying the summer anyway, you know, so it's been a great time, it's been a great summer. Things going on, and I just want to thank you for having me on, and we really appreciate all the love that you show hip-hop, and, you know, I just want to thank Jersey, you know, NYC, ATL, Miami, Japan, all the way out there in Cali, where I lived out there in Hollywood, boot camp. Shane, what up, baby?
Absolutely, absolutely. I wanted to make sure that folks know that it's been your promo that we've been playing on the show. You got a nice song with Styles P, but an Eagle. But I want to know some of the other folks that you have worked with as an independent artist. Who else have you worked with?
As an independent artist, I've done tracks with Waka Flocka. That's pretty new. Game. I've also worked with, you know, members of Wu-Tang and the Far Side. Shout out to Slim Kid Trey from the Far Side. That's my boy right there. I work with Killer Priest, Cannabis, a whole bunch of different people, really. But, you know, Styles P was like, you know, one of those dreams come true. You know, you always grow up listening to certain, you know, same thing. For me, Slim Kid Trey was one of those, too, you know what I mean? Like, growing up listening to The Far Side, you know, 1995, you know what I mean, when mm-hmm. Running was around. Now, most of y'all don't know about 1995. Now, Running was his single. All We Do Is Spark Madism with KRS-One and Channel Live. That was a hit single in 95, so I'm going back a ways, you know, but that's what turned me on about hip-hop, you know, just that raw quality to it, and just, you know. It's great, you know.
Great. Now, how did you make the transition within? Because I know working, you know, listening to them is one thing, but getting into the studio is another. How was that transition for you as you were being a fan, now being a fellow MC?
Well, I mean, I grew up around, I grew up in music, like, all my life. My father was in the blues. And he played harp, and we grew up in an urban neighborhood. We grew up in Camden, and shout out to CMD, you know what I mean? But, yeah, we grew up in Camden, so, you know, I was, like, one of the only white kids on the block. You know, I was getting beat up every day, and then but the next day they were my friend, you know what I mean? So we held down the block.
Right. You established yourself. It was like, yo, this ain't no 8 Mile, but I tell you what, I'm from Camden.
Good. My dad, he played harp. He told me all about the blues, man. Muddy Waters, Howlin' Wolf, Little Walter, Willie Dixon, Robert Johnson, you know. The people, without them, there wouldn't be no rock, wouldn't be no hip-hop, wouldn't be no
nothing. Absolutely.
You know,
that's a lot of studios in New Jersey, especially in Newark, New Jersey, Camden. A lot of jazz artists would go between the circuit of Philly, Camden, and Newark up to New York. So they would stop through here, through Inglewood as well. So I'm glad that you're giving a history lesson at the same time that we're talking about just hip-hop in general, because the foundation is built on a lot of other artists coming before you. Who are some of the artists historically that has personally influenced you besides your father?
Aside from all those bluesmen I just named, I definitely got to go with, you know, Jimi Hendrix. I mean, he changed the game forever. He did it without reading music. He picked it up and he felt it, and he was going to do what he felt, and that was it. wasn't going to hear nothing about it from nobody else. And that kind of musician, I respect that kind of musician, you know, and what he been through too, you know. But he grew up in a different kind of area, being a black guitarist in that time era. He lived in Seattle where racism wasn't going on like it was in the South. It was still going on, but just not like it was in the South, you know. It was grimy in the South, you know. But which is why I think, like, you get different types of hip-hop in different areas, you know.
Gotcha.
You got your North hip-hop, you know, Jersey, Philly, New York. We all kind of connected in a way, and even Boston. And then you got, like, you know, your South hip-hop, ATL, Miami, you know, even in the Midwest kind of, like, reflects in between the South and the North. So it's kind of weird. And you got that straight West Coast, which is undeniable, like, you know, with funk, like, you know, to it, you know, it's got, like, that you know, Parliament Funkadelic, George Clinton in it, you know, so.
Right.
A lot of great people out there, a lot of influences, but Hendrix, Kurt Cobain was a big influence of mine, KRS-One,
Getting ready to ask you, do you have any living people? I'm like, all right, Kurt Cobain and Jimi Hendrix. I wanted to hear some live folks, because it was like, okay. See, like, I know for me, Mama Cass, the Mamas and the Papas were really big influences. And learning from other genres and knowing your music history is really, really, really important. So I'm glad that you brought Jimi Hendrix and Kurt Cobain up. And you were talking about KRS and now who?
The bridge is over. I got those records right next to me.
Gotcha. it's crazy because a lot of independent artists always know that they have to work together. And I find in hip-hop, a lot of times folks will be like, oh, I don't want to work with another independent artist because I'm trying to do my thing. And you find throughout history, music history especially, you didn't have this me versus you. It's all for the culture. How do you feel hip-hop has changed over the last 20 years?
I mean, I definitely think that people are bringing more genres of music into hip-hop. In the North, though, I'd like to see a little bit more unity, a little bit more, you know, working together to maintain the integrity of what we have and what we've built up here from, you know, NYC to Philly to Jersey. I'm 5 minutes from Philly, so I'm right there, you know. Baltimore, Boston. I mean, I'd like to see a little bit more unity between those cities, but there's such rivalry sometimes, you know.
Right.
We're in the Northeast. We all think that, you know, we know everything, you know what I mean? So when we go out to Cali, we already got a chip on our shoulder, you know.
Now, do you find hip-hop to be a little bit different from New York to Philly? Is it a big gap there? Even though they're both in the North, do you find that maybe an artist in New York might not necessarily work with Philly? Because I know Philly, those artists really work together. It's like Philly, really, to me, historically, has been a place where artists, even from jazz, blues, gospel, so forth and so on, even neo-soul, everybody has tried an opportunity to work with one another. And that's been a big thing.
Yeah, in Philadelphia, I mean, you definitely have your people who do work together. I mean, like, just for instance, Jedi Mind Tricks. I mean, they work, you know, exclusively with, like, Freeway, Beanie Siegel, you know. They still all stick together and work together. And when Young Guns was around, they was working with Beans and Freeway. But then you got, like you said, like the neo-soul, like, you know, like the more what I call like a truer form of hip-hop, like the Roots. Big shout-out to Black Thought. He's like one of my heroes, man.
Right.
Of the Roots. But, you know, working together with like Jill Scott and then bring Erykah Badu into it. It's just like, you know, and every year they have the Roots Picnic, you know, they do free concerts. So they do show love and stuff. I just like to see some of the bigger guys get more involved with some of the, the independent guys, because someone once told me, they said, you know, this is a person who did me a favor and looked me out and was like, now I'm doing this for you and I'm going to look you out, but you got to promise to do this, the same thing for one other person.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
I did, you know, and I've done it for 3-4 people because, I mean, mm-hmm. and I've done the same thing because that's what hip-hop community means.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Everyone can't shine on their own. Not everyone can be, you know, the triple double on the team. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. If
you look at the perfect example, the UNLV team in basketball, everyone was a star on that team. But they passed the ball. You know, they was doing no-look passes, dunking, this, that, defense.
Gotcha.
You know,
gotcha.
It's not,
gotcha.
Just one person, not just one person on the team, you know? And, okay. you know, I wish hip-hop was a little bit more like that, you know, a little bit more, you know, everybody together, you know, like, oh, we're all into hip-hop, well, cool. If you're into hip-hop and if you're solid at all, you get respect, and that's it. It's like I worked with tons of people, and I still got to, like, prove myself and, like, earn respect from people. I'm like, damn, for real? Like, you know what I mean? Like,
gotcha.
I know you know who I am, you know what I mean? It's crazy.
Gotcha. Well, I want to make sure that folks know, really, that you are an artist who really has a stake in the game, meaning that you've been in this for a minute and have really proven yourself, especially to our audience, because I really play your music here and in the promos. But on the business side, for those artists who don't know what it means to really put the business of hip-hop, as in business first, hip-hop second, or is it all one? And what is your process?
I mean, for me, it always starts with the creative process. If you don't have a great product or something that at least comes from your heart and you believe that it's from your heart, it's a great product, you know, that's where it starts. And then you got to know your business. If you don't know your business, I mean, you could come at people wrong. You know what I mean? You could mess up your career early. I've seen people, you know, sign deals, and I'm not going to mention no names right now, but I know someone on Diddy's label. I know, you know, a couple people that was signed last year. You know, there was the big act that was signed last year. I think one that I know of is shining in Miami, and I don't know what happened to the one, and I don't know what happened to the other, but you know, they're already grinding and bitching and moaning and talking about, like, oh, you know, we got to go on tour and this. So what you think it was, man? You think
mm-hmm,
it was just,
mm-hmm.
you know, a pipe dream? You get it and you get $1 million and that's it. Like, this ain't no pipe dream. This is work. 365 days a year, 24/7, get ready to go on tour and never see your mom again.
Mm-hmm,
you know?
Mm-hmm.
You live it, you know, just like they did when it was rolling around with the blues, man. You ain't going on tour, you ain't eat.
Gotcha.
So,
now, I know that you have quite a big camp behind you as well in terms on the business side. Now, I know you've had opportunities to have sponsors. Tell us some of who your sponsors are. Maybe that might wake some of these folks up that are not working. They're just getting in the booth, dropping lyrics that basically, you know, I mean, it's originality, but then the creative part starts to get stifled. But when you know that you have to go out and prove something to people in a stage who are going to be fans, who are your direct customers, who are buying your music, you do need a little help along the way, and that's having a great business team behind you. Tell us some of who the sponsors are that support what you do.
Well, first and foremost, I want to say thank you to my manager, Shane Wall of Bootcamp ENT. I mean, Shane is a true manager. He's a true ambassador of business, of marketing. You know, there's managers out there that they'll call you once a week, you know, whatever, or once a month. I mean, I talk to Shane 5 times a day. Now, that's a true manager.
I think I do,
you know?
Too. He's like, he's about to be my manager in a minute too. No, I have a manager, but he's such a great resource.
Yeah, I mean, he's just he's steady on the grind, and like I think he sets a good example for his artists too by being steady on your grind. And then other than that, you know, I got Chris from Levitate Skateboard down in Colorado, who's also a Jersey boy, but he looks apparel and you know, free skateboards and stuff. So if I play skateboard events and stuff, I'll give decks out to kids that, you know, they got like a grimy board or something like that. Nocturnal from Philly, Nocturnal Skateboards and Apparel, they've definitely sponsored me. Bagheera Amps, Behringer Music Equipment. And then I'm working something out right now with Dude Vodka, who's, you know, they were number 5 in 2011 and number 3 in 2012 out of, like, the national vodka taste test of, like, 404 vodka. So I'm working that out. I'm hoping that one sticks, you know. I was working with Click Vodka. I'm going to throw Click out. I'm going to give Click some love. Click out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. I was working with Frank over there, but I guess I was getting a little impatient. Things weren't fast enough, you know what I'm saying? But it ain't no thing. I mean, like I say, you know, we move on, but it doesn't mean that we
right. And you know, we call it quits. We just doing what we gotta do.
We don't hate on people because you know, oh, you couldn't give me nothing, you ain't gonna give me a deal, but you know, you gotta earn that stuff. So, you know, I'm still trying, I'm earning, you know, and you know, I'm just trying, man. Every day I wake up and I try something and try new, and it's hard though. I mean, when you gotta write, record, mix, master, engineer, and then live instrumentation, MC, write lyrics, remember it, you know, and grind on your business. I'm on the computer 12 to 18 hours a day sometimes. I feel like my eyes are going to pop out of my head.
I wanted to really comment on something. I want artists to really hear what I hear. And I want to point that out, is humility. Is that it's you talk about the people that you work with and who really help you to shine more than you talk about your music, its style, how much you swag, all of this other stuff, but that you really show a lot of love to the people who are pushing you, the brand, because without them, there's no you, but without you, they would be moving on to other things. So I really appreciate the fact that you show that kind of love towards those who are helping you. And to show artists that it really, it's about you, but it's not about you. It is you, but it's not just you. I appreciate that. Now, in all of the projects that you have done, who, or I guess I would say, what would be the biggest project in life to you, to work with a particular person or to put out a certain kind of album? What's the biggest piece for you in your career?
I think, a lot of people would say, like, Wayne or M. I mean, and don't get me wrong, I mean, we may have some Wayne tracks on the horizon. I'm not going to say anything, but, you know, I'm going to give you a little clue there. But, you know, some people might say M or Dre or, you know, just incredible performers, you know. There's so many of them out there. Busta, I mean, you know. But I think out of every label, I'd want to be, if I had the ability to choose a label, I think I would want to choose Suburban Noise Records, who holds Saigon and
one of my favorites, Saigon. One of the most underrated MCs out there who really puts a lot into his craft. I love that you said that. Go ahead.
And they tour a lot. You know, they're a touring label, and they feed off each other and help each other, and I could see the family there, you know, and then, like, that's why. And plus, they throw a little bit of the rock element in there sometimes, too. So, you know, I feel like, you know, that would be me a little bit, too. Because, like, I'm about 60% hip-hop and 40% rock, you know.
Okay.
Got to throw the stars in there. They got to throw the live bass in there, you know. Just engineering and doing different things, you know, things that other people don't do. I mean, a lot of people probably don't know, but I can play guitar live and MC at the same time.
Really?
Now,
okay.
In the world that could do it yet, so. Live, let me know.
I hear you. You know what? I'm glad you said that because I'm up the turnpike from you to come in and see you perform. But I also am hearing something else come out, and it's called diversity. Diversity, not because of race alone, but because you cross genres, because you do hip rock, hip hop, and I'm sure the jazz and blues element is always there. But how many genres would you say to cross in terms of diversity within your music?
Ooh, like almost all of them, with the exception of like classical. Because classical you got violins and there's always violins and orchestral and then. I mean, so much, everything except for probably like folk, you know, but even folk can be interpreted into a way of storytelling. So hip-hop, is hip-hop just urban folk? You know, something to think about, you know, we're just storytelling, you know? Or are we talking about our rent and how much money we don't got and how many girls we don't have and we don't have, like, man. Not to say some of the MCs out there, like, get off it, yo. Like, you ain't got that.
right.
Gotta talk about something else. Talk about what you don't have. Talk about the money you wish that, you know? I mean, I try to be like that. I try to be real with my lyrics, you know? I try to be as real as possible, true as possible, you know, so that when I look in the mirror at the end of the day, I know who I am and I know who's standing there. There'd be no me without the people around me, much probably equal and, you know, just, you know, Shane and just all the people that I work with, you know, Fox on my label and, you know, Elliot Ruckus, Gene Money, CNC, everybody, Payroll Records, all these guys, man, they just all, you know, they help out, and especially with the shows and stuff.
Now tell me this, when did you know hip-hop was going to be your stop? Did you always want to do hip hop, or was it like a continuation from something else, or just hip hop just happened to be a love of yours?
I mean, I've had like two loves as far as music goes. Like, I've always loved like punk rock, and I've always loved hip hop, and it's a really weird mix too because people are like, how could you love both? You know, they're so different. But I grew up in the urban area, and you know, but I still loved, like, wailing on the guitar. Like, I still loved, like, Hendrix and stuff like that, you know. But we used to do, like hardcore, like, covers of, like, hip-hop songs. So, like, we would, like, rock out, like, heavy versions of, like, you know, House of Pain Jump Around or something like that.
Yep.
Make me rap it, you know, so.
Right.
Rap it, you know, I started to find my sound with it, like, you know, doing some hardcore with hip-hop, and then, you know, I've always, you know, rhymed, and I've always DJed. I've DJed, you know, like, so many years. Problem is, you know, you want to spin, you know, KRS-One, Five Boroughs, you know, with Vigilante, Prodigy, Buckshot, you know, Cameron. Everyone want to hear the thong song, you know what I'm saying? So
Right. Now, with the music that you do, you ever find that it's a problem that when you're carving out your niche in hip-hop that you have to change your sound to appeal to a certain market, or do you feel like your sound transcends whatever market that you're in, whether you're in the Midwest, the South, East Coast, West Coast, wherever? Do you feel like you ever have to change your sound to fit into a particular market?
I guess not my sound, but definitely my performance. Like, you know, I might have to switch up the set list a little bit because I see what's going on. I might have to get the crowd rock in a different way. As long as you rock it, and as long as you like kicking that stage apart and, you know, showing people, you know, I have no fear. I've been doing this since I was 12 years old.
Out
the stage I've been on, and there's good shows, there's bad shows. Whether you love me or hate me, you're going to love me at the end of this.
I got you.
But I do change my sound, like, occasionally. Right. You know, like, Flocka Flocka joint. It was, you know, it was his track. Like, I had to go south on it, but it was fun. I actually, like, I enjoyed it. You know, I was like, wow, you know, kind of cool. Like, you know, I never pictured myself doing, like, Southern type rap or, you know, or the game track. I had to, like, come out a little West Coast on it, you know. Or, you know, I guess it all depends on, like, who you're working with and their style and, you know, what the beat sounds like. But, you know, I try to just, you know, bring my own style to everyone else's, you know, vibe, really.
Got you. Okay, my last question, and we're going to wrap up for this session, but we definitely want you to make sure that you come through the show with the various projects that you're doing, and if there's anything in your area that we could support and come a little bit down the turnpike to come see what you're doing or to support your what you're doing around this way as well. But my my last question really has to go into studying other artists. Do you study more so other independent artists, and when is your next project coming out?
When you say, do I study artists, like, do I study, like every artist out there?
Yeah, if there's certain artists that either appeal to you or they don't, do you study them anyway? I know, like, taken from a page out of 50 Cent's book, he goes after artists. You know, like, if whoever's on top, he want to be that one to knock them off. There's some rappers like that, or there are others, because they want to work in a particular market, they'll study that artist to see how successful they are in their particular market and then do something that would help them to be successful in that market.
Okay. Yeah, to answer that question, I mean, like I said before, like, I go with what I go with from the gut, from the heart. I do listen to a lot of hip-hop artists, and I do have a lot of respect for a lot of artists out there. And just because I like you and respect you, like, you know, New York City's own Cage, I think he's got a real crazy style, you know, like Cardboard City, and, you know, I would love to work with those guys, but don't mean I'm going to write songs like him, you know, you know, if like 50 Cent and, like, you know, those bigger artists, I try to stay away from because they don't need my money, you know what I mean? Like, these independent artists or artists on smaller labels, I try to buy their records and, like, really try to, like, you know, support them because they do need my money, you know? And I do buy records. And if you're not buying records or if you're not buying downloads, then you're not supporting your craft. I mean, you gotta support other MCs, otherwise karma's a bitch. It's gonna come back around, you know. And I guess, I mean, that's basically how it is with me. I just go from the heart, and then as far as the demographic thing, you know, I feel like I appeal to a lot of demographics because, like, I mean, there is a song on, like, on my album that sounds like another song. They all got a little bit of a different appeal to it, you know?
Now, your next project is coming out, or you got a current project?
My next project, I'm working on some tracks. I did study a little bit, a little Yellow Wolf.
Okay.
I think he's amazing, and he actually wrote a track that I wrote, like, the beat, like, almost the same exact thing, like, 2 years before this track came out.
Gotcha.
But I'm coming out with a digital EP, and, you know, I'm trying to work with some other artists and get them involved and get digital EPs working with them, too. This way we can, you know, kind of get everybody together and, you know, try to, you know, get the strength in numbers, you know, like, coming from... My whole family from South Philly, they always said, you know, we might not be the toughest, but we always had our strength.
Absolutely. Well, I want to thank you so much, and especially Shane, who's been hanging out with us, too. I really want to thank you. Yep, he's right here. He's right here. Shane, give a shout-out. Shane, you there?
Yo, what's up, people? How y'all doing?
Just want to make sure he gave a shout-out, too. because Shane always supports what we're doing, always makes sure that he comes into the cypher with us. We want to thank you all for being with us here on the Q Media Nation show. You have just been inside the cypher with New Jersey's own Primavera, but he's not only relegated to New Jersey, he is all over the world. Catch him right here on Q Media Nation, and of course, when you go to the website, you'll be able to check out more of his music and more of his career on qmediagroup.wix.com/qmediagroup. We want to thank you, Primavera. Any last words you want to say before we end this segment?
Yeah, I just want to say thank you. All the love and all the support and everything you do in hip hop. You are truly the Mona Lisa of hip hop.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate it. There'd be no us without you.
Hey, anytime you want me to come down to the studio, I'm just a turnpike away. So.
Okay, I gotta hold you to that because we need to get into the studio. I need to get back into my old studio days and really do this. We can do the show from the studio too. So sometimes we can do some Ustream posts and things like that of people that you got coming through and support your career because you are one of the foremost in the hip hop industry, especially for the independent artist who's wanting to come up. So we really appreciate you being with us.
I really appreciate it. Thank you so much.
All right, peace. If there is any part of this particular interview that you have missed, we want you to tune back in immediately following the show, and you will be able to hear it for yourself. If you have questions for Primavera, make sure you send them to us at qmediagroupusa@gmail.com. Maybe there's a comment. Maybe there's a thought. Maybe there's an idea that you may have had while you were listening to his brilliant interview to tell you about diversity in hip-hop, how to have humility as an artist, and just being able to be versatile and creative while you're doing your craft, to know that hip-hop has a history, and he's part of that into becoming a legend. So we want to thank Primavera for being with us. I got to show my Jersey love to my brother. So you keep it real, keep it locked. We're going to be right back in a couple of minutes with brand new music. Go shout yourself out. Come on, Q Media Nation, and shout yourself out. So if you want to call in, it's 347-426-3974. We're going to get into a little bit of Uncle Ill and a couple of Freeway and a couple of other songs for you. But we want to make sure that you know that we're here for you. So definitely reach out to us. We got this cut by Uncle Ill. We just want to just shout it out and make sure we play it.
My life plans are serious and vigorous, like fish burning the hood. I'm furious, the fish burn is no good. I fry again with each lesson I learned. I try again, failed to plan to fail, it's obvious. The rest of this pessimist become optimist. I work hard like the Grinch, it is not a cinch until you all fear of me like a lobster pinch. Do the addition, repetition helps the process until you ain't seeing me like the Loch Ness. You don't know the time cause you clowns are watchless. My time is now and now you all watch this. Hard like trying to escape from the guillotine. Hard goddamn work like a Sidney Dean. Like a plumber doing work when it's raining crap. Hard like the rain of champ doing training camp.
I don't wanna be a loser, so I gotta get up. Yeah, I gotta get up. I know I need to get up. Get up. But I wanna be a winner, so I gotta get up. Yeah, I gotta get up. I know I need to get up. Get up.
Set goals, reach them and go past them. Red foes, eat them and outlast them. Procrastination and hesitation, what's that? I got patience, determination, won't bust whack. Winners win and losers always make excuses. Well, it's the obstacle, know the way like popsicle. Soon as I stand on top, trust me, I'ma stop giggle. Any good like collard greens mixed with hot pickle. I'm not tickle, my spot pickle to number.
number one. That number dumb, change that to what numbers come. I go hard, slow odds, the pockets bubble. Stack up the veteran work, go out and start trouble. I'm tired, my requires, the most expires. The devil's a lie, I'll acquire an empire. I shake vampires on four times for my desire. God's the umpire, sire, make me fire.
I'm gonna be a loser, so I gotta get up. Yeah, I gotta get up. I know I need to get up, but I wanna be a winner, so I gotta get up. Yeah, I gotta get up. I know I need to get up.
My mama focused hope, was raising us on focus hope. We ain't had much, cause mama and dad was smoking dope. Living broken jokes for supper, we choked our notes. With no boat to float, we suffered and hold croaked. Raised by the broken folk, not going for the okie doke. My heavenly father's keeping me from choking folks. In a moment to get up on it, I said crush opponents. Losing the losers won't condone it, because I'm on it. I rise like smoke when the ashes burn. When will you bastards learn? I have your ass to turn, cause it's my turn. You won't get a turn, because the table turned. And now you all concerned. I keep rising to the top, I keep my Dougie fresh. Lottie got out the party, do my show as yet. Playing like Hannibal, y'all made me cannibal. I get up in the morning just to eat, cause I'm animal.
I don't wanna be a loser, so I gotta get up. Yeah, I gotta get up.
I know I need to get up.
I know I need to get up. Get up. But I wanna be a winner, so I gotta get up. Yeah, I gotta get up. I know I need to get up. Get up. La 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 la.
Taking credit for the
when I'm dead and gone. I got one last wish, put my Yankee hat on.
Back, you thought you had it planned, you thought you had your man. He saw you coming, he ran when you tried to blast that man. Missed him by inches, he sprinted. Some of his boys on the corner was who your bullets entered. Two of them pulled through, but one didn't. Son's finished. You took the life of him. The part about it that's crazy, you was aight with him, tight with him. Why was he in the way? Why was he standing next to the enemy that specific day? His style never hollers loud, stays reclusive. Good dude, got that look like he always about to do. Side of his mouth toothpick, one eyebrow raised. Got into it with dude who's still trying to live out his old wild out days. They never had no problems. Somehow they rubbed each other wrong like a bad massage. These two different personalities had to collide. Cannot aim an innocent. Now you ask why, cause of an accident. Murderer, act like you killed on purpose. Liars brag you put work in. You ain't mean to murk him, your guns are virgin. Streets are full of them, read the bulletin. Accident murderer. You just an accident murderer.
We grew up doing graffiti, now hollow heads getting heated. Seated in foreign cars, constantly getting weeded. Proceeded to count profits, I know they got on binoculars. But fuck them all, we ballin' till they come lock us up. 20 to life, I'm clubbing, blowing 20 tonight. We the mall, bar, Marley, maulin' our food tonight. Addicted to wealth, never go turkey to war. Snatch your tech off the shelf, live forever, that's inshallah. Memoirs of a rich. Sweat suits, gold chains, old drug dealers. New pins, chrome rims, up a show killer. You niggas accidental, choppers in back of the limo. Pay your tithes, stay alive, can't be dodging my click. Cut a check or use your bitch for some bargaining chips. In the hole, sell your home, go sell your soul. This 45 in control, God forgive me, I don't.
Accident murderer, act like you killed on purpose. Liars brag you put work in. You ain't mean to murk him, your guns are virgin. Streets are full of them, read the bulletin. Accident murderer. You just an accident murderer. Accident murderer. Accident murderer. You just an accident murderer. For my that got killed, got hit up. Vodka spills on the concrete. Light a switch up, we miss ya. And for that girl who never made it home, shot in the dome, how they gon' kill that beautiful sister? Valid adolescents, homicidal with weapons. Not a lot of knowledge inside of their minds, and I'm guessing. Tell me who you impressing. Shooters, I knew them when they was babies. I used to test them, make them throw up their hands. Joke them up playing and wrestling. Watch them grow to a man. I see them now, they reppin'. But they cold blooded, homie. Wonder where the respect with. Can't play with these low gangsta alone. Can't hang with these low. They killin', they reckless. Wish I could bear with them. But will he change, really? Some real killers, I think of Wayne Perry. Think of my drawers, but you want a name, tell me. You ain't mean to kill him, it wasn't necessary. Accident murderer, act like you killed on purpose. Liars brag you put work in. You ain't mean to murk him, your guns are virgin. Streets are full of them, read the bulletin. Accident murderer, act like you killed on purpose. Liars brag you put work in. You ain't mean to murk him, your guns are virgin. Streets are full of them, read the bulletin. Accident murderer, you just an accident murderer. Accident murderer. You just an accident murderer. Accident murderer. You just an accident murderer.
they know me. Rockstar, only thing that's second to is OG. Really? Out here, in the club doing what? Got my name out here, out here. You can call it dipping, you can call it tricking, you can call it dissing. That is a ball of brick, number one, nothing go. So them bitches on cue like, boom in the sky when you hear us go. Let it fly, go. You only live one time, your favorite rapper up in here with one time, you know what?
You know I ain't Jay-Z, honey, but I'ma act like I ain't never had money. I'm throw it away, I'm throw it away, I'm throw it away, I like to throw it away, let's throw it away, you see me throw it away, bring it back up, hit it up and throw it away. You know I ain't Bill Gates, honey, but I'ma act like I ain't never had money.
And all my money got wings on it, stack. Booty got my sling on it. Clap, clap, clap. Make that butt applaud. You got all that back. What you frontin' for? Cheers, cheers. This is y'all song. I got riches, kitchen, and sitting y'all song. We the business, 60 in slaughterhouse, baby. This is what it's all about, baby. Money blowing in the breeze like a picture pose. I got cheese like, come. Get this money from me. I don't want it, honey. I don't make it rain. I make it snow, bunny. Climb the pole to the top of that. I ain't got it like that, but I got it like this.
You know I ain't Bill Gates, honey. But I'm act like I ain't never had money. And throw it away. And throw it away. And throw it away. And throw it away. You see me throw it away. And throw it away. I like to throw it away. Let's throw it away. You know I ain't Jay-Z, honey. But I'm act like I ain't never had money.
Damn right, I'm f***ing a lesbian stripper and a Doc Sprinter. Dick Van Dyke. Gonna love it when I go warm. Buffet throwing euros on the floor, balling on the floor. Busted slaughters in the house. Look at that click, that click. Deeper than the breaths of a fat chick, fat chick. Party in VIP with the earth grilling on loop. Now the club is smirk filling. Throw the money in the air like I'm yelling out falsetto like I know you killers on the metal type. Who give a f***? We all get a ride. I had a lap dance moment of clarity. This a tax write-off. This my favorite charity.
You know I ain't Bill Gates, honey, but I'ma act like I ain't never had money. And throw it away, and throw it away, and throw it away, and throw it away. You see me throw it away, and throw it away. I like to throw it away, let's throw it away. You know I ain't Jay-Z, honey, but I'ma act like I ain't never had money.
Here. Hit and run, hit and run. Hop off that pole, get on a different one, different one. I told her do that thing I like and she ain't do it. That was my bad, thinking that she ain't stupid. Cute face with a pretty butt, shape got it, saying giddy up, throwing ditty buck. Put it down as a pick me up. Money too long for me to be trying to see. Car murder like, even got the valet workers like. You scratch that and it's one thing, cause I'm a friend and you gon' hear the thing. Red bottoms hopping out the coupe. We got it tied up, even when we out of the loop. I tell them,
you know I ain't Bill Gates, honey, but I'm act like I ain't never had money. And throw it away, and throw it away, and throw it away. I like to throw it away, let's throw it away. You see me throw it away, bring it back up, get it up and throw it away.
And you barrel, I'm a Don and I'm rich. Watched like a federal alarm to a snitch. Germs on the wrist, sounding all sick. You can look at it and tell a little getting sick. But money don't fold, that's probably why I'm cocky. The rap deal, I owe it all to the poppies. Who live by Apollo, that be fronting me to Rocky. Then I get the white and go wild, Jeremy Shockey. Mommy kissing on the tip of my hand. Got the blood rushing to my head like a handstand. Shots come from both sides of you, that's a pan blam. Twin Glocks in my hand, call me Toucan Sam. All color stones, fruit loops. Then I'm outside looking like the goose troop. Goose troop killers right behind in the blue coupe that don't speak English, all they know me. Shoot, shoot.
Shorty, lick my thumb so I can count this bread.
Bust a bus.
The back of my dangster on. Flow water forces sliding on the beat the way you bit me sliding on the body. They love the way I drip off. Diamonds falling off and modeling and got them swallowing until they hiccup. Swag on lean.
Let's go.
Boots in their telly. With a Forbes magazine journalist up on my celly. It's wild until they push you when we step up in the spot and got them wilding with their push.
Keep it going. Come on.
Let me size them up and line them up and wind them up and show them how I be styling up on them. Throwing mountains of money, climbing on the bottom. Disrespectful in a Bentley truck with climbing. signing all up on them, controlling the forum, spending money like I ain't even seeing a bill, and it was costing me a fortune. Open up the street and blowing out of proportion, and they must salute the kid for the second and walked in. All right,
now we about to stop in Queens. Blew it up. Lloyd Banks, talk to him.
I made the flow up in 89 by 90. I was rhyming with crazy time, baby, I'm the heat. Your favorite lady moving on shady time. I stick a wee drunk, but she been digging me way beyond. With the blue lady car whipper, crazy blonde stripper. AR-15 ball scar, you lame. My conscience stay slicker, cartridge way bigger. I got Louis V on me in my carpet, great picture. Try to steal on me, I'ma stomp the bass switcher. Sure it seats long as a parking space. Got a heart like Tony and my rollie is Rose. My Cali is Kush, ballet and sniff some good. I'm a grizzly, I get busy. Got a swagger made a magnet, makes it too frisbee. So when traffic in and out, I'm starting to get dizzy. I roll a six, get the chips, take the chicks with me. Dig me.
Do you really want to be seen? Do you really want to be heard? Bootcamp Enterprises can get you seen and heard. Contact us today at 818-277-2021 or email us, shane@bootcampenterprises.com.
Once in a lifetime, the Victor Clark Collection. You will feel empowered. Wearing the Victor Clark Collection. The best things in life comes in the Victor Clark Collection. Order online today. www.victorclarkstore.com. The Victor Clark Collection, the number one clothing brand in the country, the number one clothing brand in the world. Everybody loves Victor Clark.
I want to thank you all for, of course, always being with us here on the Q Media Nation show here on Blog Talk Radio, where we know we are your source for independent thought, politics, money, music, and life. And, of course, earlier in the program, we were joined by Primavera, who is, I wouldn't say an up-and-coming artist or hip-hop artist. I would say he is already here, already doing the things that many of the independent artists that are out there should do, need to do, have to do to get your career on autopilot. So we have some opportunities for you to work with us to get your music out there, and you can hit us up at www.qmediagroup.wix.com/qmediagroup. That is our website to let you know many of the things that we're involved with. Also, if you would like to connect with us and send us your music or your video or both, at qmediagroupusa@gmail.com. You know, each and every time we're on the live show, we make a special call out to all the artists that are out there who are feeling that they are alone in what they're doing. We want to make sure that you know that we are here to help service the need of getting you promoted, marketed, and to the mass public. So if you are an artist that is out there that is doing what you do in a vacuum, but you're still trying to get out there, you're still trying to do what you do, all of this is leading to direct market campaigns to the fans whom you want to support your career to make sure that it is not just a hobby, but that it's career. Someone once told me that the difference between a hobby and a career is that one, you make money, the other, you just do it for fun. So if you're doing your music for hobbies, then we'd love to just listen to your music and listen to your music whenever we can. But if you are an artist that is out there looking for a career, then you need to hit us up, qmediagroup.wix.com/qmediagroup. I wanted to make sure that I shout out my little production assistant who's been hanging out with me during the summer, Mr. Jeremiah Tom, who's been in the studio. He makes sure that I stay on my toes and do what I have to do in the studio and make sure that I have a certain kind of focus. It's so great to see when children come and watch what you're doing so that you are honing their skills to grow up and be business people. And so my grandmother kept me in her beauty salon day after day, and I learned what it was to work in that particular environment where your customer is your best asset. And so we want to share that with as many artists as we possibly can. So if you are out there and you're thinking that, you know, just really I'm doing what I'm doing in the studio, I just don't have time to do the other stuff. Well, there are people that it is our main focus to do so. We have at cost, below cost, and, of course, no-cost options for you to get your music out there. So there's no reason for you to sit there and feel like you're alone. If you want promotional play for your music, you are more than welcome to put it on the show. Make sure that it is radio-edited so that we can get it out to the mass public. We make sure that our audience is a very diverse audience, and not only in terms of cultures and, of course, of different races and religions and all of that, but we also make sure that we make it family friendly so that we can be able to play it for whoever. Because there are a lot of people who listen to the show. There are a lot of people who learn from the show. But we want to make sure that everyone enjoys the show. So if you have a radio edited and radio ready cut of yours that you may be coming out with a new project or whatever, you can send it over to us at qmediagroupusa@gmail.com, as well as your video to qmediagroupusa@gmail.com. We'll get your video up on our channel, our YouTube channel, where artists get paid for their plays. Not that they have to pay us for plays, but that they get paid for the plays that happen on that YouTube channel. It's Indie Artist Movement. And we had last night said to everyone that we passed the 10,000 mark. Well, we're almost at 10,200, and we're going to be growing and growing and growing. The more we grow, the more money goes into your pocket. So it is in your best interest to go to the page and boost yourself as an artist if you're already on there. Shout out to Shane Wall and Bootcamp Enterprises for loading up new videos for us. We sincerely appreciate that. If you have a movie clip that you would like to expose to our audience, by all means, you can send it over to us. We'll load it up, and you can get on the show with us, and we'll make sure that we play it for you and make sure that they get the videos that they need to get on the channel, but make sure that your clips are even watched. So if you're looking for your clips for your movies, if you have new songs, if any of the interviews that we do on the show, those Bootcamp Enterprises has been so diligent in getting the videos that are out there on for us each and every day. They are loaded up. We always promote it. We always put it out there. And, of course, on our Facebook, become a Facebook friend of ours. We are also app builders. So we do have the Q Media Nation app built. We're just going to tweak a couple of things, and we'll be able to have you have it on your iPhone or your Android. So, and then we're building apps for different people. So if you want your fans to have direct, what they call push-button notifications, where you send one notification out and all of your fans who are locked into you get it, or you're able to publicize it and new people come in, imagine from your phone something you're thinking, just like Twitter, all of your friends are getting that tweet. But imagine if it is your app, and people are knowing that you're getting ready to drop a new album or a new single or a new video. You have direct access to them, and that's what we provide. Other mobile content providers will just let you just get one thing. We let you have a variety of things: digital distribution, ringtone distribution, app distribution, also the text mobile marketing distribution, and so many other types of marketing that we have out there for you to experience. We want you to be with us. We want you to grow your career with us. We are growing day by day. We want to take as many artists with us as we possibly can. We are working on a compilation album. We will be exposing new artists through this medium. And when we do the compilation album, we will be asking for certain artists that are on our compilation album to go on tour together to the venues that we set up. So if you have a hot cut and you want to be able to be down with us, reach out to us at QMediaGroupUSA@gmail.com. I think I can't say any more than that. We'll be back for another break in the program. We're going to get back into some more music. If you want to reach out to us, if you want to give a shout-out, and you're listening to us online, you can do so at 347-426-3974. Once again, we are the livest and urban online radio serving our listeners around the world. I'm Sister Falana, your host tonight, along with Miss Tonye, who is also listening in, and our creative consultant, Brother Abdul Hafiz Muhammad. We are all in the studio listening either by phone or by computer. So if you are desiring to be with us, reach out. We're not going to bite. I mean, I'm not going to come through the phone and bite you now. I might bite you if I see you. No, I'm just kidding. But if you are listening in, and to our Japanese family, if you'll be catching this on demand a little bit later, we are very, very happy to service the needs of the international community. We will have some Japanese artists that will be on with us, and we'll let you know when we do, because they're looking to do collabos with folks out there who are ready to make their music have a place in Japan. And I don't mean that you're just getting hits. I don't mean just making sales, but I mean actually going over and touring in Japan and having an already set fan base. Because what many people don't understand when it comes to Japan, Japan is a place of many, many cities. There's Osaka, there's Tokyo, there's Kobe, and of course there are other areas where there are armed force bases, the armed forces. It is a very densely populated country, of which when you do go, Osaka is like several hours from Tokyo. Don't just think when you look at the map and you see it's such a small place. That's just a small map, but it's like going from Osaka would be almost like going from, I guess I would say, North Carolina, Alabama, in those areas there, all the way up to a Boston. That's a long ride, and generally from the United States map, United States look 10 times bigger than any other place. So if you already have a market in Japan, give you a little bit of a insight as to how to market yourself in Japan. Since we've lived there, since we know the market, since the company started in Japan, to give you a layout of it is that you need to start calculating where the bulk of your audience, where the bulk of your fan base is coming from. If your fan base primarily is coming from Osaka, when you get ready to tour, I wouldn't start off in Maebashi, which is north. I wouldn't start off in northern Japan. I would start where my fan base is, and that's what we're here to do, Q Media Nation. That's how we will help you map out your tour. The same thing for Australia. If you have a tour in Melbourne, if the bulk of your audience is coming from Melbourne, but you are marketing yourself to go on tour in Sydney, and you have no place in Melbourne, and you're making your folks travel from Melbourne to Sydney, you may lose a significant portion of your fan base to come and see you at a live show, of which you have more merchandising that can go on for your business. So I just want to lay that out for you, let you know how it's really, really done for those in the independent market, how they can be one step ahead of the competition, because many of the major labels will send you to Tokyo, Osaka, all of these other places, and people forget that the smaller cities, Shizuoka, Kakigawa, and especially my home base, which is Hamamatsu, is home to the second largest population of Brazilians in the world outside of Brazil, are in the city where we are actually we actually have our business running. So that's a little bit of a tidbit. If you're going to Brazil for the Olympics in 2016, you may, for the World Cup, excuse me, the World Cup is 2016. If you want to start building your fan base in a Japanese area, the Brazilians there have family that are in Brazil, though they are in Japan. So it would be in your best interest that if you are touring in Japan, and if you have a fan base in Japan that are from some other country, to market to them, for them to take it back to their country, because many people travel for the World Cup. The same is for the Olympics. The same goes for any type of world sport. There's always entertainment tied into that. So we're here at Q Media Nation working hard on your behalf and ours, because as you go up, we go up. So I wanted to take some time out to give you a little bit of, I guess we would say marketing advice, how to help you get out there, how to help you do your thing. We had a show several months ago where we had Mr. Gary DeLamont, who came on to tell you about how to really establish yourself, what we call ringtone artists. We're working on that. We took what we learned from an interview and found a company out there that we outsource part of our work to, that you can come directly to us for, and we'll work out the deal for you where you're able to reap the benefit of having your ringtone out there in the international community where they still buy ringtones. Not everything is done the American way, so-called American way. Many of it is done completely different in other parts of the world. So reach out to us, qmediagroupusa@gmail.com. We would love to service your needs. We would love to show you what we are expanding into doing. Shout out to Four Wheel City, who has been in contact with me to help them do some more PR work. Shout out to AR, No Fear, all of the artists that come through the station, especially Big Fez, because we just connected on Facebook, so I want to to Lucci Minx, who also we would like to give a great shout out. So here we go. Neo.
Such a pleasure to it do what it do. I know you're hearing the roar of the crowd right now, but same people you see going up, you see them coming down.
Before you got your E and your brand new B and your exclusive free, I was your baby, I was your ride or die, and it's your one supply and everything you need. There was never room for either to assume you would be leaving. But now that you're brand new and getting on through, it's something to take with you.
film, you know what to do. Sing it with me, come on.
Thank you.
blessing for me too. Oh baby, oh baby, sugar is sweet when I like you. Raindrops fall, sunshine. Ooh, yeah. But when I look in your eyes, I don't want nobody else, baby.
Oh, hey.
Baby girl, you gotta look at yourself. I was the only one there when you was looking for help. Complains about my music, these the cars I was dealt. All the mess and the stressing, bad for your health. Girls follow like they at me. But your love knocked me down, it won't stop me. Your friends won't wanna see you happy, cause the truth is they wish they all had me.
I feel like I'm on repeat, cause every time that we speak, all I keep hearing is who this, change that, yeah. Who do you want me to be? Can't you just love me for me? I can't go on for much longer. You want me to change the way I walk, change the way I talk. You want me to change the way I am, but I can't do it. I'm just one man, I can't do all of those things. But can you do one thing for me? Look at your reflection.
How do we stand it when it's hard to manage? Damn, I thought you would ride like transit, but I guess I was wrong. Should've knew it all along. Now I'm stuck with a picture, blowing up your phone. Take a look, though, we far from perfect. You can leave if you don't think I'm worth it. Went from late night walks to late night talks. I don't think I ever changed, but it ain't my fault.
You want me to change the way I walk, change the way I talk. You want me to change the way I am, but I can't do it. I'm just one man.
We definitely want to thank you all for tuning into the Q Media Nation show. That was Jay Magic coming in from South Africa. We've been on the phone, of course, answering tweets answering emails, text messages, all of that. So we want to, in the last few minutes of the program, we're going to bring back some more music. But I wanted to shout out for next week. We're going to have, of course, our new Music Monday. And on Tuesday, we're going to have coming on Mikey D, whose songs you've been hearing, as well as Angels, Inc. and Lyle Rockwell. Lyle Rockwell, you know, is really a U.S.-born artist who's really making a lot of noise in the Australian market. And Angels, Inc., they've been here before, but they are some cats who really know what it means to do touring on the guerrilla marketing tip. So they make sure that they keep their camp tight. They make sure that they do what they need to do to push their album sales. And we just want to welcome them back on because they have a new project that's out. We want to make sure that you, the audience, know who it is and who they are. We will not be on Wednesday of next week. We will be doing a on-demand show as well as a previous broadcast, so we will be able to push that out to you. You'll hear about it on our Twitter and, of course, our Facebook. And as always, you know to keep it locked right here on Q Media Nation on Blog Talk Radio. Again, for music submissions, QMediaGroupUSA@gmail.com. If we're not on live, you can always reach us at 201-203-1983. To all of our face group folks, you can get into the Q Media Nation group by going to Facebook and putting in your search engine Q Media Nation at groups.facebook.com. So if you want to be a part of the Q Media Nation group to know on Facebook when we are getting ready to do something, I always will put up official admin posts that's for anyone who has a payout coming from us, from their YouTube views, any of the important information coming from the show. The group is growing. We have maybe about nearly 150 people that are locked in, but that 150 people means that they represent maybe four or five other people. So the group itself is, you might see the numbers are low, but those are sometimes labels, artists who is the main artist from a particular camp, and so that particular person belongs to the group, if not the whole group. So shout out to DJ Reality, who they have a campaign going called They Are the Problem. So We Are Problem is in the Q Media Nation group, and they're making big noise in Europe. So shout out to DJ Reality and her whole camp, because they're all so locked in with us. They've been with us nearly since the beginning when we started out, to Nels, who's been with me since I was in Japan, to K Banger, who's also been with us since Japan. And we're also looking for independent artists who would like articles written about them. So that's qmedianation.blogspot.com. Become a friend of ours on there. Follow the blogs that are being posted. And as always, always, always hit us on our Twitter, because we do post a lot of messages. I know Bootcamp always makes sure that we're at the top of their list, so we want to make sure that you know that. If you've been texting on the text alert line, that 201 number is no longer necessary to use, because we're going right into the apps, and we will be going into another mobile marketing campaign where we send out one message and it goes to everyone's phone directly. So we will be launching that campaign probably in the fall. And we have some other companies that we need to highlight, some offshoots from the Q Media Nation group. There are some companies that are little small companies that are popping up. And thank you to Yum Yum for helping us to get that out there. And, of course, we have our Ustream channel. We don't use it as much, in our Spreaker channel that we are going to be moving into. So we want to ask that if you have a mixtape, an uninterrupted mixtape, we would love to highlight it or debut it, give it a world premiere status here on Q Media Nation Radio. If you have an uninterrupted mixtape, we will dedicate 1 hour to an up-and-coming or rising mixtape artist. So make sure that the tracks are radio ready. I know a lot of the mixtapes, you got to use a lot of crazy stuff on it, but listen, if you really want to get it out there, we will promote it, we will get it out there. Just make sure that 1 hour we do what we do. Shout out to Vinyl Digger, who is still a vinyl artist who mixes a lot of vinyl overseas in Europe, and he makes sure that he sends us his mixes. So you can catch him on SoundCloud, but at the same time, we have some of his mixes here with us on our sister station, Spreaker.com. So you want to know all of this, go to qmediagroup.wix.com/qmediagroup, and we'll be happy to receive your music. We'll be happy to let you know more about what we're doing, and of course to always push the independent artists. That's first and foremost what we do with the show. We will have the state of our mental health within the hip-hop community, the urban community, and just the community at large, what our mental state is and what we're doing. We will also have a health segment that we will be making sure that for your health and wellness, keeping that up, we have a brother named Carlos who is a chef, but who also has a wellness program that he'll be dealing with, because there are a lot of people in the hip-hop community who are affected by diabetes, like Fife and some others, as well as cancer. You know, we lost one of the Beastie Boys earlier in the year. So these are the things that we need to keep our ears and eyes open. You know, for many of our jazz artists, they may have died at a much older age than many of us in the hip-hop community. However, that does not take away from the fact that our health, our wealth, and our wellness are all part of our career, all a part of us. Nothing is separate from us. So we're also going to get into some money aspects in regards to having the proper insurance as an artist. What does it mean to have that as an artist? If you don't know, you should know. We are so fascinated by Rough Riders, and it is their father whom I learned a lot about with the insurance business. Their father taught me a lot in regards to that business and how important it is to have insurance and go into business. If you have a business to support your career, you may not always be jumping around on the stage or producing or anything else like that. But, you know, if you have another business that lends into that, we know we have lawyers who are also producers, who are also business people that work along with us. So we have a lot of social workers. So there are many facets to the hip-hop culture. We just have to make it as a family work. So we want to shout out to all of the independent artists who have given us the opportunity to play their music. We enjoy doing what we do. And, of course, as always, we are your source for independent thought, politics, money, music, and life, and we want to make sure that you know that you're locked in with us. You know this is a house built on a solid foundation. So shout out to Shane Wall, Boot Camp Enterprises. Shout out to Open Vision Networks and Doc, who works along with that. And to the other Doc who's in Las Vegas, we want to thank you all for being with us. And as always, 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 we love you. One love, one family, one nation, Q Media Nation. We appreciate you. Have a great weekend, and we look forward to you being with us next week. And if you have new music, send it to us so we could debut it Monday night and play it throughout the week. And we're going to get into a couple of other songs, and then we're out for the weekend. Have a great weekend. Stay cool, stay hydrated, and we will see you when we get back.
Throwing money in the air like I don't really care, yeah. Standing on the chair like I don't really care. Got by the fair, I'm baller of the year. And haters everywhere, but I don't really care. No, I don't really care. No, I don't really care. Got by the fair, I'm baller of the year. And haters everywhere, but I don't really care.
Flocka, flocka!
Ah!
keep them bad, bad melanin. Throw it down, rich in hell, plus I'm throwing down. Trunk is down. And where I go, I'm yelling bridge for Monopoly. Loud as hell. Money in the air, and I don't care. 50 for the earrings, that's 100 for a pill. Versace on my ear, two beds for my underwear. For boring cars, foreign bras, baller of the year. Buggles on my champagne, Independence Day. I ain't really want your number, your friend look better anyway.
Throwing money in the air like I don't really care, yeah. Standing on a chair like I don't really care. Got by the fair, I'm baller of the year. And haters everywhere, but I don't really care. No, I don't. Too much money to fold up. Keep some roll up. I run it like a motor. You see the way I pull up. Dancing like a soldier. What you expect to happen? Now I'm swagging on the sofa. I be so reckless. Spend $100,000 on my necklace. That mean my two cola. My neck rose polar. Bitch, yeah. Baller, yeah. We can take it there. I ain't never scared. Throwing money in the air like I don't really care. Yeah. Standing on the chair.
Yeah, let them hate me, mug on back, yelling out, I'm getting cake. 10,000 work for ones on the way. He ain't playing with a 10, little mama, he just flexing. He came with two, she left with me, intercepted. He saying he gon' kill me when he gets me, but I don't really care.
No, I don't, I don't.
Do you really want to be seen? Do you really want to be heard? Bootcamp Enterprises can get you seen and heard. Contact us today at 818-277-2021 or email us, shane@bootcampenterprises.com.
Young Clem, we in here. 5 o'clock in the morning. It might be 3 though.
I said I see some ladies in here tonight. I might marry. Gone off the belly and throne. It's too scary, baby. You can have whatever you like. It's too scary. I do anything to leave it tonight. What you share? I said I do. I do. I do. I do. I do.
You know I do.
I said I do.
If I get you open, all the things that I would do to you. Smack it up, flip it down, weigh it up, break it down. Lean you to your side, yeah, and ask you who's your daddy now. You gotta even open your eyes, know what you're looking at. And I ain't have to open my eyes when I was cooking that. Guess it was love at first sight, eye contact. Remember the night we first met, I caught a contact. Now she my ride or die. It's us against the world. You know we both hustling, so hustling is our world. Took a month to have, too much to drink. I'm in my G mode. So all the ladies repeat after me, cause it's a G code. Promise if I get locked, you come and pay my bond. If he hits them again plotting on me, you ring the alarm. And that's how you get to me, it's gonna be the bomb. And in these unlucky streets, you gon' be my lucky charm. I can't see some ladies in here tonight, I might marry. Going off the belly and drone, it's too scary, baby. You can have whatever you like, it's too fairy. I do anything to leave it at night. What you share, I said, I do. You know I do. I said,
I do. Promise to treat this game IDO. Honor the code, not bring drama to mama's peephole. Life's obsessive, but she's the only love that I know. So let a day after the I do's, let's do Mercedes. Let's tie the knot, let's grab us a pot, let's make a baby. Looking back, I don't know who threw this bouquet to me, but I walk down this aisle faithfully. Cut that cake for me. I, Jay-Z, take this unlawful lady to have in the hole, into the task force, bro. To hug her every corner till I get ash from the cold. Only to love a master fortune, too much cash for me to fold. Fold under pressure, I would never, ever, ever, ever. Your secrets I treasure, for better or worse. You'll always be my first love. To test you with hard.